I have been diagnosed with melasma 15 years ago, and over time, it just spread all over my face. It has taken over my life. I have to put loads of makeup on, because otherwise I can't go out, I can't go to work. Even my family never seen me without makeup.
My mom is, she's an amazing person. Very selfless, incredibly caring, always wanting to go above and beyond if she can. As the melasma has got worse, I've definitely seen a change in the way my mum sort of approaches day-to-day life.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi, Mum. You know, I like to take her out for dinner if I can, or celebrate occasions, birthdays, and take us out as a family. And often, she'd rather not. How's things with your skin?
It's probably got worse, if I'm honest.
Worse?
Yeah.
How bad is it? Can you show me? And if you see her face, amazing face of makeup, you know, she does it really, really well. But to her, it's, you know, it's almost like those layers don't protect her from how she feels inside.
That patch is there, it covers my whole face.
It's so dark, I didn't realise. I mean, that's much darker than, I think back to when I first saw it on your sort of upper lip. Well, thanks for showing me, I appreciate it.
I'm even scared of my face, really. Who would want to see this? My son is getting married later this year. I should be very happy, he's my only son, you know, but how would I look on the day? So yeah, very anxious and scared. Well, if Dr. Emma can help me, then that will change my life forever.
Hi there, Bernadette. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Dr. Emma.
Come with me. Come on in, Bernadette. Just have a seat up on the bed for me. And this is Nurse Motti.
Hi, hello.
So tell me what you've come with today.
I have a skin condition called melasma. It's all over my face.
OK, so you must be a complete expert in applying makeup then, because I can't see anything.
I tried. It's 15 years of, you know, mastering it, so yeah.
And when it started 15 years ago, had you started on an oral contraceptive pill, or was it around the time of a pregnancy?
I was on the pill, but I didn't really notice.
What do you think makes it worse? Is it worse in the winter or the summer?
Summer is worse. It's darker. Yeah.
It's darker. Mm-hmm. So one of the reasons why people get melasma is that they have these pigment cells called melanocytes, and they make melanin, which is the reason why we have the colour of skin that we have. For people who have melasma, for some reason, those melanocytes are acting abnormal and they're making more pigment than they should do. Things like pregnancy and the oral contraceptive pill trigger it off in the first place.
Okay.
You seem that this is having a big impact on you, is that right?
Yes, yes. Have anxiety over the years and depression. I feel like I can't function. I can't do anything. I'm just constantly hiding.
Yeah.
And it's like I'm wearing mask every day. So I don't even want to look at my face.
Because you don't like the look of it?
No.
I can see that it's really upsetting you, isn't it?
I feel really sad and bad.
Oh, it's upsetting me that you're upset. Okay. Well, my job is to figure out how we can start to get things a bit better for you. So I know it's going to be scary to take your makeup off, but if we can have a little look,
okay,
and then we can make our treatment plan of what we can do, okay?
Okay.
So if you just lie yourself back and you can pretend you're in a very posh spa.
Thanks.
And this is your therapist for the day.
Let's see how well you've done this makeup. Wow, you do have very good makeup on.
Okay, Bernadette, so that's all off now, so I can have a good look.
So what we're looking at here is pale brown to dark brown pigmentation, and it's got the edge running quite clear to see. And then it also has these areas of kind of a paler colour in between it. They're called confetti-like lesions. I have got a special light called a Woods light. Okay, so we'll pop all the lights off. Okay, so you keep your eyes closed for me. If things look worse whenever we're using the wood light, we know that the pigment is in the superficial bit. And if it doesn't really make much of a difference, then we know it's deeper down. You can see the edge of the melasma a lot more clearly here. This is certainly not an easy type of melasma to treat because this is in both parts of the skin.
I've used a special light called a Woods light to try and identify where the extra pigment is in Bernadette's skin. There are three areas that it could be: the epidermis, the dermoepidermal junction, or the dermis. And in Bernadette's case, it's in all three areas. So that means I'm going to have to throw everything at this. There's going to be tablets, there's going to be creams, there's going to be radiation or sun protection, and there's going to be lasers, lots of lasers. It needs all of these elements or it just won't work.
So this morning I've got all the instruction from Dr. Emma on how to use all my creams. On a daily basis, the first thing in the morning. This is very important to protect my face from sunlight. And to put it all over my face.
For the last 2 months, I've been doing all the creams that Dr. Emma prescribed. I'm back here today for my laser treatment, and I want to show Dr. Emma the difference. Yes? Thank you.
Hello.
Hello, Dr. Emma.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
And how is the skin doing?
It's better.
You can tell by your smile. Okay, let's get you down and we'll get the makeup off. Start the treatment. Oh, it looks great already, Bernadette.
That is absolutely
brilliant. It's so much lighter.
Yeah, I'm so impressed.
Yeah, it's really, really good. Okay, let's pop the goggles on.
Those are for you. Lovely, relaxed. Yeah.
Okay, Bernadette, you're just going to feel a little wee bit of heat here, okay? Here we go. So this is just a very gentle laser. And the idea is to start to break up the pigment a little bit more. So all of the sounds you hear is the laser just beating up the pigment. How does that feel, Bernadette?
It's okay.
Not too hot?
No.
When it comes to using lasers for melasma, you need to do multiple treatments, usually spaced a few weeks apart and over usually about half a year. And the reason for that is that you have to use low energies. Because if you don't, then the high energies will just promote more pigmentation. So this is a low and slow process. So, boom, how did that feel?
It's okay.
I cannot believe how great your skin is looking. So much lighter. So I normally tell people at 4 months we'll start to see a difference, and you're 7 weeks into your treatment.
Yeah.
This is amazing.
Dr. Emma, do you think my skin will be cleared completely?
I think that there's a good chance that we should be able to get this all clear for you. Look at your wee face.
I'm so emotional.
The important thing is that it will only stay away if you're really diligent with the creams and the sun protection at home.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, good. I am so impressed with how well her skin is responding to the topical skincare as well as the medicines that we've given her.